Welcome back. In the previous video, we saw how protection acts in a grid-connected microgrid. In this video, we will see an example on protection in islanded mode of operation. In detail, we will take a look at the protection behavior when an internal fault occurs in different locations in an islanded microgrid. As mentioned in the previous video, one of the main protection challenges in microgrids is the low overcurrent generation by the distributed generators during faults. Generally speaking, conventional electrical machines, such as asynchronous machines that are directly connected to the electrical network, are very sensitive to disturbances. Their fault current may reach 5 or 6 times the value of the nominal current. This makes fault current detection easy for the protection schemes. However, the electronically interfaced distributed generators have a much lower current, in the order of 1.1 to 1.2 times their nominal current. In such cases, this low overcurrent value makes the fault detection process very difficult. This is even more challenging when the microgrid is operating in islanded mode. In this mode, there is no fault current from the main grid, making the overcurrent even lower. Let's see what happens when F1 occurs during islanded mode. Just as discussed, when having high participation of distributed generators, there can be a sensitivity problem, enhanced by the fact that there is no high short circuit current from the grid. There are two possible solutions to overcome the lack of sensitivity. As the microgrid has very low short circuit currents, the first solution is to connect a new source, such as a diesel generator or flywheel, which can provide high fault currents. However, this might increase both investment and operation costs of the microgrid. The second solution is to implement an adaptive microgrid protection, where the microgrid control system continuously analyzes the structure of the network and actively adjusts the settings of the overcurrent relays in such a way that the protection scheme properly works for different types of system operation and location of faults. We will elaborate more on adaptive protection in some examples in the next videos. If the fault occurs at F2, this would mean that it was caused from the neighboring distributed generators. The setting for CB2.4 are adjusted in such a way that they are just slightly higher than the rated load current of the distributed generators, causing it to trip. If CB2.4 does not trip, then switchboard 2 is isolated by CB2.5 using a directional overcurrent relay. In this case, no sensitivity or selectivity problems are foreseen. It is worth noting that both the protection settings of CB2.4 and CB2.5 can be different during grid-connected and islanded modes of operation, since these two breakers are required to trip at much lower overcurrents during islanded mode. In summary, we have seen in this video how microgrid protection works in islanded mode. To tackle the low sensitivity challenge faced by the conventional protection schemes, an adaptive protection scheme is sometimes implemented, as we will see in the next video.